The first part of the process is to make your connections to the circuit that's under test. In this case, we're using an iFlex and a variety of other modules. After making the connections, turn on the modules and make the modules discoverable, called the finding and binding process. Simply turn on the module, make sure that you do press the radio button on each module. You'll see the radio icon noted in the upper left part of the display. That tells you that the module is in fact broadcasting. Make all of the modules discoverable to either the computer or the DMM, whichever one you decide to use. In this case, we're making a connection to a remote panel for looking at an HVAC system and the command from a thermostat to temperature on a combo core boiler. And we're also making a connection back to a service panel to look at not only the command from these devices, but the current that's coming through to that circuit. Step number two, turn on the meter. After turning on the meter, press the radio button. Once the radio button is pressed, it will poll for the different modules to determine which module is available to be seen on the meter. Next, use the up-down arrow key and the select key to highlight the ones that you want to display. When you push the select key, it reverses the selection and you'll see which ones you've actually selected to be displayed. At that time, make sure you push the up-down arrow button for 2 seconds to finish the selection process. Now, you have everything on the screen at one time that you need. The designation of each module can be customized through the computer connection, which is covered in a later video. We have an AC module connected to the command from our thermostat, and the flashing radio button does confirm the connection to the multimeter. Each module displays independently whether it's synced or not, as each one does have its own display, as well as the ability to log. You can see here we have 3.1 amps going through the circuit. You'll note that the radio button will flash momentarily, saying that it is connected to a DMM, as well as giving the ID number that is associated with the display of the DMM. You'll also note that on the DMM, we are connected to voltage and we're taking a look at frequency in this case, so the DMM can actually have a fourth reading. Finally, all required readings are visible on one screen for you.